Welcome to Sturdivant Hall. This house was built in 1853 by Colonel Edward Watts. And shortly after that, he sold it to John Parkman. He sold it for the sum of $65,000. At the age of 17, he got into banking and he became a clerk and worked his way up until the age of 29, he had become the bank president. Unfortunately, he was not a very good investor. And after the war, he had invested heavily in cotton futures, so he lost a considerable sum of money. The people in Selma felt that he was honest and that this had just been an unfortunate train of events, and many other bankers had lost money in the same way. But the federal government felt that he had embezzled this money. So they came down and arrested him, threw him in jail down at Old Cahaba, the original capital of Alabama. And he was awaiting trial there. The citizens of Selma were extremely upset over what had happened, and they felt that since he was so honest, that they just knew he could never have done anything like this. So they devised a way to break him out of jail. And they decided that they would put on a big Mardi Gras celebration out in front of the jail, distract the jailers, and break him out of jail. So this is what they did. They put on a Mardi Gras celebration. Some sources say that they probably bribed the jailers a little bit. He did, in fact, break out of jail. And he was getting ready to set foot on a barge that would take him down the Alabama River into safety when one of the jailers that apparently had not been bribed saw him, shot him, or shot at him. And some sources say that they actually shot him and he fell in the Alabama River and drowned. Other sources say that he was scared to death and dove in the Alabama River and got caught up in the paddle wheels and was killed that way. Some sources say his body was never found, but other sources say that he's buried in the old Live Oak Cemetery. The story goes that on his way to jail, he vowed that he would never leave this property until his name was cleared. And because his name was never cleared, he's never left this property. Don't see him real often, but sometimes people have been known to see him. We have had someone to say that they had seen him. They were here on Thanksgiving, we had had a jewelry sale here, and the clerk was packing up her stuff, and she was actually looking in the hallway, and all of a sudden got a real strange look on her face, and the director at that time asked her what was going on, what was wrong, and she said, "Well, you've got a ghost in this house, don't you?" And the director said, who had never seen John Parkman, said that, "Well, you know, some people say we do." And she said, "Well, I just saw a man in a top hat and tails from about the 1850s walk through this room. I was sitting here one day, I was by myself, and I heard someone come up on the back porch, and the door opened and there was no one there." From time to time, things move around and doors shut, and we see maybe a glimpse of something is going through a room, but he doesn't seem to mind us being here. And we get a lot of mileage out of people coming to see him.